Life for the Jews before the Holocaust was honestly not a bed or roses. Even before the Holocaust, the Jews were an outcast group in the Western culture. They were often driven from their homes, their culture attacked, and their property seized. They were also forbidden to enter into various cultural groups and occupations. Much like the residents of the districts in the Hunger Games, even before they rebelled against the capital and more or less started the war, they didn't have an ideal life. Before Katniss Everdeen entered the Hunger Games, her life wasn't much better. They were often driven out of their homes and had their property seized. They didn't get much to eat either, and were always the outcast of the capital. And they were always forbidden to enter anywhere outside of their district. In the late 1800s, the Germans created and passed laws that restricted the Jews in certain occupations, such as teaching. Much like how the capital set certain jobs to each district, how one would work in the mines and another would supply and work for materials. Before Hitler came to power in the early 1900s, many Jews decided to flee the country, but many were denied this due to restrictions against them in other countries.
Jews were forced to live in specific zones and cities called ghettos. From there on, Nazis were taking Jews to death camps.
Marcus Reich was a boy who was lucky to escape certain death. He was challenged to survive against all odds in the wilderness, facing the constant threat of Nazis and diminishing health. The tributes, especially those who had less experience and come from poorer districts, face similar challenges in the arena. There is the constant fear of being killed by other tributes whilst also facing starvation and natural threats set by the game maker.
Just a game, but I'm not having fun anymore. We're telling these lies and we laugh and we cry.
Hitler Youth was a paramilitary group which was founded in 1922. It was formed to try and train boys from the age of 14 to 18 to fight and become soldiers. They were taught that the Germans were the Aryan race or perfect race and that everybody outside Germany was inferior. They were taught how to kill others just like the tributes in the Hunger Games were taught to kill the other 23 tributes. The tributes in the Hunger Games were all taught to kill other people and some of them didn't want to, just like in the Hitler Youth where some German kids also were forced to join and were then forced to kill.
The arena was kind of like a concentration camp for the tributes. They were stuck in there, forced to die. But before they did, they wanted to get everything from them. For the tributes, it was fame. Get their hopes high. And for the Jews, it was labor. Hard work. And if they couldn't do that, they would be shot, gassed, or killed in some terrible way.
I just want them to change me.
How would they change you?
I don't know. They'll turn me into something I'm not. I just don't want to be another piece in their game, you know?
You mean you won't kill anyone?
No. I mean, you know, I'm sure I would. Just like anybody else when the time came, but yeah, I just keep wishing I could think of a way to show them that they don't own me.
Anne Frank was a girl, 13 years of age, who wrote a diary about her experiences during the reign of Hitler. We find that she is courageous and smart, much like Rue from District 11. She was also kind and trusting, she cared for others and always saw the best in people. She did not let her circumstance change her or bring her down, she remained strong and determined.
Peacemakers are much like the Nazis, they commit terrible acts under the influence of their leader and inflict fear upon the people. The Nazis' main purpose is to torture and kill of the Jews, and the peacemakers use torture and manipulation as a form of control. They publicly display their power and advertise their authority.
The German people would roam the streets, trashing the place and making their mark, as did the peacekeepers, blowing up districts, killing, beating, and punishing people for the smallest things.
Adolf Hitler was much like President Snow. His main priority was to gain power and control. Hitler was the head of Germany, and within his reign the Holocaust began. He ruled that Jews were impure and sent them to their deaths. Much like President Snow, casting out and punishing all those who were part of the rebellion. The Jews were treated unequally, just like those in the poorer districts.
Why do you think we have a winner?
What do you mean?
I mean, why do we have a winner? I mean, if we just wanted to intimidate the districts, why not round up 24 of them at random and execute them all at once? Be a lot faster. Hope.
Hope?
Hope. It is the only thing stronger than fear. A little hope is effective. A lot of hope is dangerous.
If history repeats itself, then where are we headed? History doesn't actually repeat. Each event doesn't happen over and over again, but the themes themselves are seen throughout major historical war or rebellion. Unjust action, military, socially, and politically still take place, but are governed by different leaders and involve different nations. Wars always promise a better outcome. Rivalry and rebellion acts on the hope of surrender, and those greedy for power are the ones who determine the fate of those who have no voice. In such a world, we cannot expect improvement, and we have not learned from past mistakes. Yet we see the relapse of terrible events take place throughout history, and we can only expect more. The development of new technology and media will make the annihilation of entire races in the future not only possible, but easy. Future wars and uprisings may be the ones that only last a short matter of time, but their effect will be one to echo on forever and change the human race and the generations ahead of us. The base to fight justice still exists and repeats in different ways throughout history. The Jews conducted an uprising against Hitler's rule and worked underground to bring in weapons to ghettos and fight off the Nazis. In the Hunger Games, anger and hope produces rebellion in small amounts, and those in the districts survive on hope. In future generations, media will be the new face of change and rebellion. We can already see the effects of media on international issues and the truth as the truth is brought forward about issues that are cached by broadcast media. As we see in the Hunger Games, people rise up out of the apocalypse and rebuild their lives. Although future isn't much different to the time we live in now, there is still poverty, war, and leaders are still unsympathetic and greedy. From this, we can assume that there will be another relapse and a plague of violence, uprising, war, poverty, and rebellion will take hold, and countries with little resources will fall, and a new way of humanity unless we change.
Unless we change.
Unless we change.
Unless we change.
Unless we change.